Hello friends, my name is Nurullah Taş. We are together with a new lecture of our ChatApp series. In this lecture, we are going to sign up and send data to Firebase database. To do this, let's click Do not have an account. If we click Already have an account, we are turning back. Then let's click this again. I want to sign up with my mail address. I can use bbb@bbb.com to show you as a sample. My password can be 123456. And then let's sign up. New account is being created. And we are going to main activity after sign up. Now let us come to Firebase. We can see users in here. Below database in data, and we can see users also in authentication aaa@aa.com, bbb@bbb.com. Let's start. First, let me close all opened windows. I am going to sign up activity. In here, let me open sign up XML tool. I have email, password, and button, and already have an account. First, these are my controls. Let me define the controls in Java. I have one button, private button. It can be creating register button. I have two edit text, private edit text, user mail, m can be upper. User password. I have one text view. Let me call it already have an account. These are my controls. I must define them with their IDs. Defining the controls. Create register button, find view by ID r.id.signup button. Let me copy this line a few times with Ctrl D. I have user mail, sign up email. I have user password, sign up password, and I have already have an account. Let me see the ID of this text view. Already have an account. Okay. First, when I click the already have an account, set on click listener, new on click listener. Intent, I want to go to sign in page. Sign in intent. New intent. I am taking sign up activity dot this, and I am going to sign in activity dot class. I have to start activity sign in intent. Sign in intent. Okay. Then when I click to the this button, I want to take these inputs from here and send these data to Firebase database. To do this, I have to define Firebase. We added Firebase database libraries at first lecture of this series. Let me define a database reference, user reference, and then private Firebase auth, m auth. I have to defining the controls. Defining Firebase. M auth, Firebase auth dot get instance, and then user reference equals Firebase database dot get instance dot get reference. And I will use a progress dialog, progress, private, progress, dialog, loading, dialog. Let me define it, progress, and then progress, loading, dialog equals new progress, dialog. I have to give a context this. And now, when I click to the creating register button, I want to register the user. So I come to here, creating register button that set on click listener, new on click listener. I am going to use a new method in here to create a new account. Let me call it create new account. When we use methods, we have to use brackets. And then I am coming to one of my method. I press Alt Enter from my keyboard and create method. And in sign up activity, it has been created. In here, I am going to take user information and send to Firebase database. First, I will define two variables. My first variable can be email equals. I will take from user mail dot get text to string, and the other can be, let me use Control D. Other can be password, and I am going to take it from user password that we defined above. And now I am going to use if condition in here. If text UDLs is empty email, then warn me. I have to show warn with toast message. Toast that when we write toast and press to tap from keyboard, it is coming automatically. Let us warn the user, you have to write an email address, and I want to show this long. And now I am going to use another if condition in here. If text UDLs is empty password, then show me warn again. I'm going to use toast. You have to write a password. I can use exclamation in here and in here. And if user do not write email or password, the app is going to warn user that you have to write an email or a password. If user fill both fields, and then we are going to use as, I'm going to use loading dialog in here. I will give a title to dialog. It will show us new account is being created. I can use exclamation in here too. And then loading dialog dot set message can be please wait. Loading dialog dot set cancelled on touch outside true. That means when we click a field outside the dialog, it is going to be cancelled. And then at last we are going to show loading dialog dot show. We came to most important part of taking and sending data from user to Firebase database. We are going to use out dot create user with email and password method. I am going to use email and password parameters that I take from controls from here. And then when I want to send data to Firebase database, I usually use add-on complete listener method, new on complete listeners. I am pressing tab. I can close here with semicolon, and then I will use an if condition in here too. Android Studio gave us a task in here. What is our task? Our task is creating user with email and password. If task is successful, let me use the condition. If task is successful, then we are going to do something in here. We can write a few minutes later. Let us give if task is not successful as we are going to warn the user. Let me create a variable, string variable, message equals task dot get exception. I am going to warn the user with error message, and I can show with toast tap. Let me write error colon plus. Let me show message variable in here plus, and I want to give user the warn in here. Check your informations. I can use exclamation in here. I want to show long this message long, and then I want to finish the loading dialog with dismiss. If the task is not successful, the app is going to show a warning to user that check your informations, and the app is going to close the loading dialog. In here, if the task is successful, then we have to send the data to Firebase, and I am creating two string variables in here. One of them is device token. We are going to use later for some tasks. Device token equals, it's going to take from Firebase instance ID dot get instance dot get token. And the other variable is string current user equals current user ID equals mout dot get current user dot get UID, and then user reference dot child. I am going to give a new field to Firebase database. I am going to show a few minutes later these two. I have to write it in double quotes. I am going to give user for Firebase field dot child, create a child under the user's current user ID, and create a child under this current user ID that device token. And I created a field in Firebase database users, and there is a child of user current user ID that I take it from mout.getCurrentUser, and then I created a child that device, I call it device token, and I want to set value of this field with device token that I take it from Firebase instance ID that dot get instance dot get token, and I am going to use this token later. It is important for us. After the we created field in Firebase and we set value for it, and I am going to use an intent that main intent equals new intent. I am going to take sign up activity dot this to main activity dot class, and when I press the back button from my phone, I do not want to come sign up page again, so I have to use add flex in here. Main intent dot add flex intent dot, let me write in here new task, and intent dot clear task. Then I can start activity main intent, and then let me finish this intent, and I can show a toast message to user that new account created successfully. I can use exclamation in here, and then I want to dismiss loading dialog dot dismiss. Dismiss is going to lose the dialog. I think we done in here. We can take user informations and we can test our app. But before we test, I want to come to my browser to Firebase. Let me show from beginning. In here, our chat, I am clicking here. First, I have to come to authentication and set up sign-in method. I must change this as enable. I am saving this. We can see it is enabled. Then I am coming to database or choose real-time database, create database, start in test mode. This is important to test our app successfully. Enable. We can see our rules are public, read, write, true. I want to come to data and then returning to Android Studio and running my app. And my app has come. I do not have an account. I click this. I came to sign up page. Let me write aaa@aaa.com and my password can be 123456. I click sign up. New account is being created, please wait. And it sent me to the main page. It is wonderful and beautiful for us. Now let us come to our database. We can see users. Under the users, this is user ID that VI8. We can see from authentication that VI8. This is user ID. And let's see in database. This is our device token field and we took device token and sent it to this field. We done all we wanted successfully. This is our lectures and I hope you good study. See you later. Thank you for joining us.